to bring you the constant variety of sport, the thrill of victory, and the agony of defeat. This is ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Today on Wide World. At 17, Shannon Miller is the most decorated of all American gymnasts. Last year, she became only the second U.S. woman to win a world all-around title, and she remains focused.
My main goals as far as competitions for this year are Goodwill Games and World Championships.
For Dominique Dawes, last year's World Championships were a sad memory. Her quest for a medal ended on her final vault.
Okay, you gave it a good shot.
This year, the setting is Australia, and the talk down under is of the domination of the American women gymnasts. For Dominique Dawes, it's a chance to redeem herself. And for Shannon Miller, a chance to make history as she attempts to become the first American ever to win consecutive world all-around titles.
Hello everyone, I'm Julie Moran and welcome to ABC's Wide World of Sports. Today, Shannon Miller looks to take her place in history by attempting to become the first American ever to successfully defend a world all-around gymnastics title. That dramatic competition begins our coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships. In addition to our coverage of today's women's all-around competition, we'll bring you a special two-hour edition of Wide World tomorrow at 4 Eastern Time as Shannon Miller continues her quest for gold in the women's individual event finals. And we'll also have the men's all-around competition. Also today, we'll talk with newly crowned heavyweight champion Michael Moore, who last night defeated Evander Holyfield in Las Vegas. But right now, let's join John Neighbor, Kathy Johnson, and Bart Connor for the World Gymnastics Championships.
Almost halfway around the globe from the United States of America is the country continent of Australia. And situated midway down its eastern seaboard is the city of Brisbane, and that's where the world's finest gymnasts have gathered, including 17-year-old Dominique Dawes from Silver Spring, Maryland. After her first rotation, she is the leader at the World Gymnastics Championships. Today, we bring you the women's all-around competition. Dominique Dawes getting ready for the balance beam performance.
Ever since the World Championships last year in Birmingham, I've seen a level of intensity and confidence in Dominique that wasn't there before.
She gained so many fans last year with her smile, her personality, and her really aggressive performances going for the gold in the last rotation.
Talk about aggressiveness. She is very aggressive on this event. Watch this first pass, how she attacks it. It's three layouts in a row. She sets it up with a back handspring. Look at that, right to the end of the balance beam. Been for the last year. She's won every competition she's been in since the World Championships.
I found this amazing the other day in the preliminaries. She was on the beam, she left out a movement, and she was able to look down to the end of the beam to see the scoring timer and add a few arm movements to make sure that she filled enough time so she didn't get a deduction.
Watch this dismount pass. Two back handsprings to a full twisting double back. Very nice performance.
Dominique Dawes had a 9.85 in the uneven bars for her first rotation, and this event was outstanding. She's going to score close to that here as well.
I'm John Neighbor, and welcome to ABC's coverage of what is the most significant and prestigious gymnastics competition of the year. Today we bring you the women's all-around action, and Kathy Johnson, the American women competing here today, are heavily favored. In fact, a local paper even called them a superpower of gymnastics. What can we expect?
Shannon Miller is still very capable of winning the all-around again, though she's not the overwhelming favorite that she was last year. She's had to deal with some nagging injuries and a growth spurt, so she hasn't been able to train quite as intensely as she would have liked, particularly on the uneven bars where she's still a little weak. Though she's getting better every day, it's her first event, and I think it's going to be a key event for her. Dominique is just so incredibly physically strong, and so many people here are very excited about her in the competition. She's been hot all year, consistent since the last World Championships. I think she has the best chance to challenge who I consider the favorite, Lavinia Milosevic of Romania, who's doing a very high level of difficulty and doing so extremely well.
Now, before we bring you that action, I should point out that the format of these championships has recently been changed in a very significant manner. Instead of the usual qualifying round, this year's field of 67 gymnasts was divided into three groups, with the athletes in each group completing all four rotations in a single session. Session one has already taken place. We're now in the middle session, and at its conclusion, we will begin session number three. After all the athletes are done, the winners are determined by the highest scoring totals. Now, each country can only enter one gymnast per session, so as you can see, Dominique Dawes and Shannon Miller will not be competing head-to-head. So, Bart Conner, that begs the question, what impact will this format have on the outcome of the contest?
Well, this is certainly a big disadvantage for Dominique Dawes that she's not competing in the final session here. Now, the reason being that the judges tend to be very stingy with the scores in the early rounds of competition, perhaps keeping the door open for some stronger performances later on. Now, if Dominique Dawes, however, can hit great routines in this session, she can put some pressure on Milosevic and Miller, who are going to go in the final round.
Our all-around competition will take place in the vault, the uneven bars, balance beam, and floor exercise. Dominique Dawes received a 9.812 for her beam routine, so here are our standings midway through the second session. Now let's go to the floor exercise, where our leader, Dominique Dawes, is getting ready for her routine. Her friends call her Awesome Dawson.
Dominique first gained attention at the Olympic Games in Barcelona on this event. She was only 26th in the all-around, but everybody saw her on the floor exercise because of her outstanding tumbling and just an exciting presentation. Watch her opening tumbling run. It doesn't stop. Whip backs. You do a double twist punch front, back the other way. Now watch this, 2.5 twists to another punch front. This is a new routine since the Worlds last year. It's to Malaguena.
That, of course, was the same music that Christy Yamaguchi won to win the figure skating title in Albertville.
She has packed this routine with difficulty. Full twisting double back. And she finishes with a high-rated dismount, 2.5 twist. You can see she is really attacking the landings. That is the sign of a competitor on every single landing. She could have bobbled. She had so much energy and power behind them. But she really went for a perfect landing and fought it.
She really does make terrific decisions in the exercise. This opening tumbling run seems to draw the crowd in because once they see her head back the other direction and dazzle you with more complicated tumbling moves, everyone in the building can't help but watch Dominique Dawes.
Watch this full twisting double back in piked position, and look at the landing. She puts that head back to really show it off.
And this was a key to the routine, the 2.5 twist, as you mentioned. She was over-rotated, but watch how she lunges out of it and dances out. Lovely presentation and cover-up. It's great when gymnasts overdo things rather than underdo things.
The judges' marks for Dawes a 9.80 on the floor exercise as she sits next to her coach, Kelly Hill. The land down under is such a special place that the locals are quick to point out many of the unique charms of this land.
Of all the true blue animals native to Australia, the old kangaroo has to be one of the favourites. We'll have an optic of the little joey in Mum's pouch. What a little bottler. And the koala, well, he's quite happy just hanging around. And the highlight of his day is the occasional scratch. What a life.
ABC's Wide World of Sports is brought to you by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today. Hewlett-Packard DeskJet Printers. DeskJet Printers from Hewlett-Packard. Make it happen. And by Kellogg's. With good taste, nutrition, and value. The best to you each morning from Kellogg's.
The 15-year-old Lilia Podkopayeva from the Ukraine is next up on the beam.
Lilia is such a polished gymnast. From her perfect toe point. And look at her posture. Always stretched up tall. Which is hard to do when you're 4'8". Very tiny gymnast. Now watch this pass. She does a pike open down to the balance beam. Head spin on the balance beam. She's also performing a very difficult dismount, full twisting double back, just like the one we saw Dominique Dawes perform. Landing is crucial. Excellent.
Every gymnast is told by their coach to point their toes, but few gymnasts do it as well as Lilia. Great polish.
Next up is Dominique Dawes on the vault. The first time she ever faced this kind of pressure was a year ago. Kathy Johnson has more.
Dominique Dawes came into the 1993 World Championships as a virtual unknown on the international gymnastics scene. Her personality and charm captivated the audience, and after three events in the all-around, Dominique was in the lead. On the vault, her final apparatus, she went for broke. Attempting a vault with the highest degree of difficulty, she had the chance to become champion of the world. It was a gutsy move. With a heartbreaking result.
That position. You have to be happy with yourself. Be happy.
Well, in the beginning, I was pretty upset, but then knowing that I came in fourth in the world, I was just really excited.
You can do it. Stand up and wave.
She had even more to be excited about. Two silver medals on bars and beam.
I guess I was more motivated and more confident after that Worlds because I did a lot better than I expected to, and I went home and trained a lot harder.
But Dominique's focus and determination have been challenged recently by forces beyond her control. Her parents' separation has caused her to grow up quickly, but fortunately, she hasn't had to do it alone.
You're better on your board. Do you feel better on your board?
I feel safe. It feels fine.
All right. Let's do one more, and then you can stretch out.
I know she has times when she doubts herself or her abilities, and we're constantly working on her confidence. Tell her I believe in her. I believe that she can do it. I'm always saying, you can, you can.
Kelly has coached Dominique for 11 years, since the first day she stepped foot in the gym. Recently, Dominique moved in with Kelly and her family. The two see themselves as friends, as well as coach and athlete.
Kelly helps me a lot outside of gymnastics. She asks me a lot about school, and a lot that goes on with my personal life, and just things and how they are at the gym.
When not training 6.5 hours a day, Dominique is a senior honor roll student at Gaithersburg High. Her academic achievements caught the eye of numerous universities, and just recently, she decided to go to Stanford.
Most of my fans are going to be disappointed when I leave gymnastics and go to collegiate gymnastics, because they've all written to me and asked me and told me that they really wanted me to go to 1996 Olympics.
As a 92 Olympian and a world championship medalist, she is now fulfilling another goal, to receive a gymnastics scholarship and a valuable education. Dominique has held steadfast to her own dreams.
I don't think her awards and rewards and everything that she's earned has affected her personality. And I think people can learn from that. She's a beautiful person.
And she's hoping for a beautiful vault. This is her first of two attempts. The scores will be averaged as Coach Hill looks on.
This is a critical event for Dominique Dawes. She had trouble on the landing at the last World Championships in Birmingham, performing a very difficult vault, and she's doing the same vault here. 1.5 twist. Oh, no. Oh, no. This is a repeat of the last World Championships. Unfortunately, now, with the rules, they have to perform two vaults and they average the score of both. This vault will count. She was on the short end of the horse, so she was in trouble from the very beginning and just could not make the correction in the air. Completely over-rotated.
In the warm-up here, she was under-rotated, so it looked as if she was trying to overcompensate, perhaps, and she way over-rotated. What a shame. It's so hard to land anyway, but when you don't get a good block off the horse, you can see she is upset.
This is very sad. And this second vault now is for pride alone for her to come up with a good vault. She has so much support here in this arena.
Potkapayeva's score on the beam was a 9.837, and now Dawes is getting ready for her second vaulting attempt.
This vault is worth a 10 in the code of points. Much better vault, but even a step on that landing, it's not going to be a big score.
Well, like last year, once again, a surprising disappointment for Dawes in her final rotation. We'll be right back. Well, Dawes with a much better second vault receives an average of 9.506. Next up, Gina Gojian, a 16-year-old from Romania, on the floor exercise.
Gina is very fortunate to finish up on her best event. She's an excellent tumbler. Whip back, good, a full twisting double back. Primarily because of the landings. She is in such control. Ordinarily, Gina would not have a chance of passing Dominique Dawes in the all-around, but because of the mistake on the vault, she has a perfect opportunity here.
And this is a better routine than we saw from her last year. Folk music from Romania.
Strong routine.
Not much of a reaction from Gina Gojian. Octavian Bello, who is her coach there, said in a press conference the other day she speaks about 5 words a week.
The best part of this exercise is the control she has on her landings. Watch this. No movement at all.
And watch how cleverly she choreographs the ending of this front tumbling. Rather than risking trying to stick a landing,
She steps through right into a pose. Well done.
There really wasn't anything spectacular in this routine, but she had all the requirements, plenty of difficulty, and no deductions for landings.
Well, Kathy, the judges give Gauchon a 9.787 for her floor exercise, and that puts her ahead of Dominique Dawes here at the completion of two of the three sessions. Bart Connor is down there with Dominique now.
Dominique, you're second after this session, three brilliant events, and then vaulting. Can you tell us what happened?
I think I just pulled it too hard to rotate, and then I rotated.
Now, you're very aggressive in all your performances. Is that what you were thinking before you went up to vault? You have to be aggressive?
I guess, I don't know. I was just trying to pull too hard, and it didn't work.
We saw the look in your face after your first vault and this shock. Obviously, you're still upset a lot now. What was going through your mind after your first vault, knowing you had to do another vault, and your chances for an all-around title were gone?
Well, I was thinking that I still have another vault, and the vaults do get average, so I thought if I get a better score, maybe it would bring my score up a little bit.
Well, good job, and you still earned a lot of fans here.
Thanks.
Now marching into the arena, the gymnasts of the third and final session, including the defending world champion, American Shannon Miller.
We'll return in just a minute to see Shannon Miller attempt to become the first American ever to successfully defend a world gymnastics all-around title.
ABC's Wide World of Sports continues with more of the World Gymnastics Championships.
Two-thirds of the athletes have already completed their turns on the apparatus, and so now the third and final session gets their chance to post their scores. This session includes some of the finest performers in the world,
including 17-year-old Lavinia Milosevic, who, from Romania, is the leader of perhaps the strongest team in the world.
Shannon Miller was so dominant last year, she was expected to win. If she could pull it all together here, it could be a very emotional and personal victory for Shannon.
And where do you see the performances from this 14-year-old mini-mite, Mo Hui Lan from China? She's been a real crowd favorite here. She'll be doing a move that's never been attempted in world competition before on the uneven bars.
We start the first rotation with Milosevic on the floor exercise.
Remember at the opening of the show, I said this gymnast has such a high level of difficulty, particularly in this event. And what's nice about this gymnast is that she could do easier passes and still fulfill all the requirements and the code of points, but she chooses to do highly difficult vault tumbling passes. Beautiful opening, double layout.
This is a critical pass.
Whip back, through to a two and a half twist, punch front. I'd love to see her make the adjustments on the landing. She does them in a way that there's no deduction. Now watch, she ends with a triple twist. One of the most difficult tumbling passes to end with. Almost came up a little bit short, but such a talented gymnast. Pulls it right around. Bart, it's really going to take 9-8s to win this all-around competition.
She is so tough, and she expects so much out of the performance. The opening tumbling run is the laid-out double somersault. Technique is so good.
See how she's just slightly forward, but she steps right into the lunge.
This pass was crucial because she had trouble in the practice sessions making the two and a half twist and completing the punch front. And as you said, she adjusted beautifully on the landing.
Here's the triple twist. Nice tight form. And she can tell she's coming up a little bit short, but she changes the body position to get it all the way around.
What a talent.
Milosevic receives a 9.812 from the judges, a good score in the first rotation. Now Shannon Miller, the 17-year-old from Edmond, Oklahoma, begins her defense of last year's all-around title. She's over at the uneven bars.
This is the most critical event for Shannon Miller. Because of her injury, she hasn't been able to train as much as she'd like on this event. She's still doing an excellent routine, just working a little harder to do it. Watch this combination. She'll go full over the bar. One of the first female gymnasts to ever perform it, right into a release move. One and a half turn, right into a transition.
Right on. She struggled a little in the preliminaries, but so far this is beautiful.
Her dismount is a double layout somersault. This is what she had a little trouble on in the preliminaries. Best she has done all week. She has got to be thrilled with that.
And you know, her coach, Steve Nuno, is. Steve said she was speaking just at the right time. A lot of people didn't think she'd be ready to give that kind of performance here in Brisbane. Boy, that was great.
This is the best section of the routine, and this is the best she's done it since the World Championships last year. Perfect distance from the bar. Now watch this new part in her routine. One and a half turns right there. Back to the low bar, right to handstand.
Miller receives a 9.85, a very good score, and it puts her a bit ahead of Milosevic after the first of four rotations.
Hey, we're not just some small offshore island. Australia is an entire continent.
Coast to coast, it's almost as large as the U.S. Now we lead off our second rotation with 14-year-old Mo Huilan. Now this is a gymnast that China is certainly grooming for the 96 Olympics in Atlanta.
And what a talent. She has no real weaknesses, which is amazing for a gymnast this age. She combines difficulty and polish.
So clean.
Music is adorable.
Well, if she doesn't figure into the all-around here, this is definitely a future star.
She's 4'3" and 64 pounds. And so powerful.
Another full twisting double back. And she fought for the landing.
Exciting. You know, one of the great things about coming to the World Championships is you're always looking for who's going to be the future star. Well, boy, we have one here.
We'll have her scores in a moment, but now we turn our attention to the vaulting area where Milosevic is getting ready for her first of two vaults. She trails Shannon Miller at the end of the first rotation.
Lavinia has had so much success on this event. She tied for the Olympic gold medal in Barcelona with Henrietta Noti of Hungary. A world champion in 1991 and was second last year at the Worlds. Very powerful vaulter. Oh, beautiful. Yurchenko vault with the roundup entry vault into an Arabian front, and that is a difficult vault to land.
She gets a terrific push off the horse, great tight body position, which allows her to hold tight on the landing.
Well, Bart, Mo Huilan and her typewriter music received a 9.725 on the floor exercise, and her best event is still to come. You can see Milosevic's mark for her first vault. Here comes her second attempt.
Great score. All she has to do is repeat that exact same vault.
Remember several years ago, it was just the best of the two vaults. Now, because they're averaged, both vaults have to be excellent. You can't just get lucky on one.
in the replay, you can really see how difficult this vault is to land and why. The gymnast cannot see the mat, so her body has to be in perfect position to stick the landing.
So Milosevic's two vaults give her a 9.812 score for the rotation. And we watch Shannon Miller at 17, already a veteran of major world and Olympic competition. Dominique Dawes can merely watch from the crowd. So our leader, Shannon Miller, is now ready to mount the beam.
This is the event that when I first saw Shannon Miller as a junior gymnast, that I thought she was exceptional. She has always had an uncanny sense of balance. Has always performed an extremely high level of difficulty. Just a slight balance check there with the arm. Layout step outs. Now here's the Miller. Beautifully done.
Wow, right to the handstand. That's as well as she's ever done it in competition.
I think she's settling in. She looked a little nervous at the beginning of the routine to me. Big dismount. An important landing here. Round off. Full twisting double back. Great landing. Exactly what she needed to do.
You can really sense her confidence growing as the competition goes on, even as the week goes on. When they arrived from Oklahoma about a week ago, they were a little down and wondering if she was going to be able to get it together. And as you can see, her coach, Peggy Liddick, impressed with that exercise.
Great angle to see how narrow the balance beam is. Very little room to work on. She is just right on. Two layout step outs. Nice form throughout. Perfect landing.
The dismount is a full twisting double back. The most difficult dismount you can do on balance beam, and she's right in line.
Miller's score, a 9.862. That increases her advantage over Milosevic halfway through the contest, but she leads by less than a tenth of a point. We now begin the third rotation, where Milosevic is trailing Shannon Miller by less than a tenth of a point. She's over at the bars.
Here's an amazing statistic about Lavinia. She has been world and or Olympic champion on every event. The only thing she has not won a gold medal in is the all-around. High release move. She looks a little tight. Second release move. Best part of the routine. Double front dismount. But a step on the landing. She doesn't have a routine that has amazing difficulty, but she has enough. It'll be worth a 10. I think she was a little bit tight in that. It wasn't like she was going for every single element right in handstand. She might be a little nervous. Here's her first release move from low to high bar.
In this sequence here, you can compare her with Shannon Miller, whom we saw earlier on the bars. These elements are very nice, but not the same level of difficulty that we saw from Shannon, and this transition to the low bar is nowhere near as impressive.
Here comes the dismount sequence. She does a giant with a half twist, double front, very difficult to land. Can't see the ground, and she takes that step forward.
The marks for Milosevic, 9.775, and that'll keep the pressure on Shannon Miller, who's now getting ready over on the floor. There's a sense of history here. Remember, America won its first ever world all-around title on the strength of a spectacular floor exercise routine, the year 1991. The athlete, Kim Zemeskal.
Although Shannon certainly isn't thinking about that moment right now, she does have a chance with a strong performance here, as well as on her final event, the vault, to do something that no American has ever done, and that is repeat as world champion.
Score over 9.8 here, she could really set herself up going into the final event to win the all-around title. Some of Shannon's new front tumbling work.
Because Shannon has grown 4 inches in the last couple of years and had to struggle with some injuries, it has affected the level of difficulty in the last part of this tumbling routine. She has plenty. The judges certainly appreciate her acrobatic elements, but to the gymnastics fan, it's a little watered down, isn't it?
Fortunately for Shannon, the new code of points, though there's certainly some faults in the new code of points, it's working to her advantage. She can now do front tumbling passes that are not as physically challenging, yet earn the bonus points from the judges, like this one. Oh, no!
He was in trouble. Good cover.
She really had to work to pull that out, but it will be a deduction. We'll see how severe.
Good comments from Steve Nuno. He said, hey, you pulled it out again. We'll point that out, and we see the replay of the last tumbling pass. The opening tumbling run was right on. This is the last tumbling run. Handspring laid out front full, right to a punch, handspring, and then to a front. She was way short of rotation. It would have been very easy to fall back on her heels and perhaps even onto her rear end. She covered, as Steve Nuno said, and danced right out. It will be a deduction. The judges don't miss that.
Miller's score, a 9.750 on the floor exercise, and though she's still in the lead, Romania's Milosevic has narrowed the gap.
ABC's Wide World of Sports continues with more of the World Gymnastics Championships.
China's Mo Huilan is next on the vault. Though not in medal contention, she has proven herself a contender for the future.
Can't say enough about the talent of this young gymnast. Very powerful. Handspring front, pike position with a half twist. Very difficult vault, especially from such a tiny gymnast.
You're right, and normally being short is a huge disadvantage on this event. Her power is very deceiving. Beautiful double front flip with a half turn. Great technique. And she's barely as tall as the horse.
There's Mo's score for her first vault, and that'll be averaged with the score she gets here.
She'll try to get a little more rotation on this vault than she did on the first one. Nicely done. An indication of how powerful she is watch the pre-flight, which is the section from the springboard up to the vaulting horse. Watch how high her heels get when her hands actually meet the horse. Right there. That allows her to get rotation and power.
So with the two scores averaged together, Mo receives a 9.687 for this rotation. When we return, Shannon Miller competes in her fourth and final rotation, the vault, where she has a chance to make history. Last year, when the medal was placed around her neck, Miller became only the second American to win a world all-around title. No American has ever done it twice. She has the opportunity to do so today. Here are the standings after the third rotation in the third and final session. So one event remains to determine the world all-around champion, and that final event for Shannon Miller will be the vault. She's getting ready for that now. But before she gets an opportunity to compete, we'll be watching Milosevic from Romania try to turn in a stellar beam routine in order to go by Shannon Miller, at least to put the points on the board.
Incredible pressure right at this moment to finish up on balance beam. She needs a very solid performance. Side somersault, difficult landing. That could be the difference, depending on what everyone else does. Very nice pass. Four elements down the length of the balance beam. Two of them somersaults. Excellent.
Oh, she's a little shaky.
I noticed from the very beginning, she's just been tight. She's nervous all of a sudden. That's the way that skill is supposed to be done.
Landing is going to be critical.
Pretty good job, but she has definitely opened up a slight little window in there for Shannon Miller. This was the best pass of the entire routine. Back handspring layout.
The dismount was a round-off double back, slightly over-rotated. Boy, it's going to be close.
Milosevic gets 9.837 from the judges, and even with that slight bobble, that's the highest score she's received on any one of the four apparatus. Now for Shannon Miller, the time is at hand. One final event separates her from her second world all-around title. Miller comes to this defining moment with impressive credentials.
When the 1992 Olympic Games ended, Shannon came home to a hero's welcome in Edmond, Oklahoma. After all, no U.S. gymnast, male or female, had ever won 5 medals in a non-boycotted Olympics. Suddenly, all eyes were on Shannon Miller.
I'm used to being the underdog, you know, up until the Olympics, and now it's just a different role coming into a competition, being on top.
After having missed the Olympic all-around gold by just 12 thousandths of a point, Shannon entered the 1993 Worlds as the favorite. And in one of the closest all-around competitions in the history of the sport, she won the gold by 7 thousandths of a point. Today, at 17, Shannon aspires to what many believe is an improbable goal, competing at the 1996 Olympic Games. If she's to realize her dream in Atlanta, she will have to defy the odds of a prolonged career in an unforgiving sport. Since her unprecedented success, she's had to contend with nagging injuries and a growth spurt of more than 4 inches. But Shannon believes that she can beat the odds at age 19.
There's only 2 years left until the Olympics. I thought it'd be, you know, long, hard training, which it is, but not quite as bad as I thought. It's a lot of fun still. Mostly what keeps me hanging in there is that it's going to be in the U.S., and I think that's going to be really great.
Two vaults remain. She needs a 9.775 average to win the all-around gold.
If it's possible to be comfortable in this position, Shannon Miller is. She has been here before at the Olympic Games in Barcelona. She finished on the vault, and she needed to stick her landing for the silver medal. At the World Championships last year, she had to stick both vaults for the all-around title. Here it is. Ooh, difficult vault. The same one we saw Milosevic do. And she had the hop on the landing.
The U.S. team, including Dominic Dawes, encouraging their teammate for the chance of a world all-around title.
She had excellent form and power on this vault, but she did pike down a little bit at the end, causing her to over-rotate and have to hop. It'll score well, though.
She scored a 9.80 on the first vault, so now she needs a 9.75 or better to win the gold. And, of course, Milosevic watching from the sidelines. Her fate is in Shannon's hands.
Beautiful job. Excellent vault. It was a better vault. She opened up a little quicker. As you said, she was tight coming into the landing on the first vault. She opened up a little. You just had to take that step forward.
Steve Nuno saying it was a better vault. That was a better vault. Very close to where the judges are, as if perhaps his encouragement will remind those judges that she's going to need more than a 9.75. to win her second world all-around title, never been done by an American.
This was a much better vault than the first one. Notice how much higher she is off the horse, and look at this stretch position right here, which enables her to come up with a better landing.
Milosevic awaits the scores. Miller needs a 9.75. She's done it. Shannon Miller, the 1994 World All-Around Champion.
And stick around, because 14-year-old Mo Hui Lan will try to make history in her final event.
But there's another world champion in Brisbane. It's Shannon Miller, America's first gymnast ever to successfully defend a world all-around title.
We still have some vaulters left.
But other medals are still up for grabs. The 16-year-old Dina Kuchetkova from Russia was in fourth place at the start of the rotation. A 9.95 on bars could earn her the silver.
She has had a tremendous competition so far. But nine nines are really tough to come by in this competition. Look at that full pirouette into reverse heck. Right down to the low bar. Exciting routine. Unique. Different types of difficulty than we've seen so far in the competition. Big dismount, double layout. Great competition.
Really excellent form and technique.
Beautiful form. Watch the dismount. Laid out all the way through, and great landing.
The marks for Kuchetkova, 9.825, and that score will give her the bronze medal. So with the medals decided, there's still a treat in store, folks. Mighty Mo Hui Lan is a fresh new face with an arsenal of tricks. Every once in a while, the sport's witness to a breakthrough performance. At the 1972 Olympics, Olga Korbut provided the thrills.
Jim, if she hits, you won't believe that she's the second best on her team. Now watch this. Watch this. Back somebody right to the other bar.
Has that been done before by
never,
a girl?
Never. Not by any human that I know of. Look at that. And she's second best. I don't believe it.
That is a historic performance you're watching right now in gymnastics.
She's Kathy Rigby size. Oh my, wow!
all we can say is you are not going to believe this. First time we have ever seen this on the uneven bars. First of all, leading up to it, look at the amplitude. Perfect form. Here it comes.
First time ever in world competition.
Front flip over the bar. It's invented by Mitch Gaylord of the United States, who performed it on high bar. Here's where she had trouble in the preliminaries.
Oh, she made it just barely. She does everything in the book on the unevens. And another release move.
Here's the dismount, double layout. I love the way she puts her hands right to her side in the air.
What a treat.
Just to make sure everyone knows, not only is it hard, it's a great routine, but it was easy. I said 9-9s are hard to come by. I think we might just see one.
Now, the move that she does is a 1 3/4 front somersault, but what makes it most difficult is the fact that she has to fly over the bar and then make the catch. Outstanding.
Well, the crowd loved the performance, and so did the judges. The score, 9.90 for Mo. That's the highest score awarded in this contest. Great performance. So as we see our final results, see your medalists on the screen, and American Dominique Dawes finished in fifth place.
The one heartbreak of the competition came when, after performing three spectacular routines, possibly worthy of an all-around title, Dominique fell on her final event.
Here's Bart with the winner.
Shannon, congratulations on an absolutely outstanding performance. You have to know that coming in that there were some people who didn't think you may be able to pull it off again.
I had a couple injuries earlier this year that I had to come back from, so I was really hoping that I was going to be able to train hard for this competition. This is really important to me.
The last vault, did you know that you needed a 9.775 average to go ahead and take the gold?
No, I didn't even know what place I was in, so I was really happy when I finished.
Okay, so you're standing there getting ready to go for this vault. What kinds of things are going through your mind, knowing that if you hit a strong vault, you could probably win the gold?
Mostly just going through my vault drills, making sure that I was trying to stick my landing.
Now, last year you came in here as a heavy favorite, and you won the competition. This year, it wasn't exactly the same case. So you're standing up there listening to the national anthem this time. How different does it feel this year as a repeat champion?
I think it's even better this year, just because I wasn't the favorite coming in, and I've had a rough year, you know, with injuries and everything. And just being able to come back from that, for me, that's really something to look forward to.
Congratulations on a terrific performance, and good luck in the finals.
Thank you.
Join us again tomorrow as we continue our coverage of the World Gymnastics Championships. Shannon Miller goes for more medals, and Dominique Dawes gets another chance for gold in the individual event finals. And the men will vie for the all-around title as well. For now, we say so long from down under. See you tomorrow.
That's our show for today. We'll see you tomorrow on a special edition of Wide World. Good night, everybody.